Welcome to an entry in our exclusive 3 Steps to Gladiator series. We built these guides from the ground up to help players go from zero to gladiator, even on a spec that they've never played before. Step 1 covers building your character and is essentially everything you need to get started once you hit level 120 on your class of choice. Step 2 builds upon that by preparing you for 2 of the most important skills to have in Arena. Finally, Step 3 walks you through how to get the best results when entering the arena. Now, we're excited to announce that throughout December, we'll be bringing you daily releases on the second step in this series for all of the specs that you see on screen right now. So, if you're looking to kickstart your climb to Gladiator on any of these popular specs, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified the moment your guide goes live. And head on over to skillcap.com/wow if you're interested in checking out the rest of the series along with hundreds of other exclusive BFA guides. Alright, let's get into today's Step 2 release. Enjoy!
Hey guys, welcome to a 3-part series called 3 Steps to Gladiator. In these series, we'll cover Step 1, building your character, Step 2, preparing for PvP, and Step 3, entering the arena. In the second part of this 3-step series, we'll talk about preparing yourself for arena. In the previous video, we talked about talents, Azerite traits, and gear. And in this video, we'll talk about min-maxing your healing and mana efficiency, and getting the most out of your crowd control. The first step to min-maxing your healing and mana efficiency as a Resto Shaman is to avoid using Chain Heal too much. The Tidebringer PvP talent increases the value of your Chain Heal, but using Chain Heal too much will make you run out of mana fast. When out-healing minor damage, you should only use Healing Wave, Riptide, or your totems to top summon back up for maximum mana efficiency. Chain Heal should only be used when you have to quickly top a target, for example when a target is about to die, or before you get caught in a CC chain to quickly top the target before you sit through the CC chain. If you are forced to use Chain Heal to top your target, make sure you always combine Unleash Life with Chain Heal for maximum healing output. Healing Stream Totem and Riptide should be used off cooldown for maximum healing and mana efficiency. Healing Stream Totem offers you some passive healing while keeping your target stalled with casted heals. Riptide is your instant healing ability, which also leaves a shield on a target if used below 50% health with the Surging Tides Azerite trait. Using Riptide grants your stack of Tidal Waves, stacking up to 2 times, which is why you want to use Riptide off cooldown. These Tidal Wave stacks should then be used to reduce the casting time of your next healing wave by 30%, or to increase the critical strike chance of your next healing surge by 40%. Your main use for Tidal Wave stacks will be Healing Wave to keep your target stopped as mana efficient as possible. Never use Riptide if you already have 2 stacks of Tidal Waves active, since you don't want to waste a stack of Tidal Waves. Instead, cast a Healing Wave or a Healing Surge before using Riptide again. Earth Shield should be active on the target that's being pressured at all times, to increase your healing on the target by 10%. This means you will have to swap your Earth Shield around accordingly to the target that's being pressured throughout the game. Avoid doing damage with Flameshock and Lava Burst or Purging until later in Dampening or when you already force a ton of cooldowns from the enemy team to save mana. Assisting your team with damage or purging costs a ton of mana, and doing either too early can result in you throwing the game if you run out of mana before your team is able to score a kill. Both Grounding Totem and Wind Shear should be used to avoid big damage abilities like Chaos Bolt or Greater Pyroblast to save mana when trying to play mana efficient. Grounding Totem can also be used to absorb Maledict Trinkets if you know the enemy team is playing with them. If you're being pressured instead, utilize your Ghost Wolf with Pack Spirit to heal yourself. This is especially useful when your line of sighting is CC and damage at the pillar, and you won't have to waste any mana on healing yourself for maximum mana efficiency. Moving on to the second part of this video, we'll talk about how you can use your crowd control. Resto Shaman is the only healer with an interrupt, which can be very valuable depending on what comp you face. Wind Shear generally should be used to interrupt big damage abilities like Chaos Bolt or Greater Pyroblast, or any CC on you or your team like Polymorph or Fear on off targets while the enemy healer sits through a CC chain and while the kill target sits through a stun. However, using Wind Shear on the enemy healer when your team has pressure can create even more pressure for your team, depending on what healer you face. For example, purging a Holy Paladin on his Divine Favor, followed up by a Wind Shear, will create a ton of pressure for your team. Landing a Hex on either the off target or the enemy healer can also create a ton of pressure for your team, but you should be careful when trying to Hex. To land a Hex, you will have to push in and play offensive most of the time, which can easily backfire with a swap or CC chain on you instead. Only push for a Hex when your team has pressure and if you have any sort of CC or interrupts to stop CC on you. Also keep in mind that mages, shamans and druids can dispel your Hex, so only go for a Hex when you know it won't get dispelled instantly. Against classes that can dispel hex, you will have to avoid using hex unless you know they're not able to dispel the target, for example with Cross CC, or if the line of sight behind a pillar. Capacitor Totem can be used on targets to extend the CC chain. You should never use Capacitor Totem to start a CC chain, since most experienced players will simply kill it before the totem triggers a stun effect, which is why you want to time it to proc for when the target is about to come out of CC. Purge is not necessarily a crowd control, but spamming Purge versus Wrestle Druid and Mistweaver teams can create a ton of pressure for your team by removing their HOTS, which can easily score your team a kill without any crowd control. However, spamming Purge makes you quickly. Only go all in with Purge spam when the enemy team has no cooldowns left and your team can score a kill, or when you're playing a melee cleave and you go for an all in strategy. That's gonna be it for step 2, preparing for PvP guys. Don't forget to leave a plus skill if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next part of this series.